Adam's grammar school is set to close after immense debt left the school in special measures. The multi-million pound sandwich empire on a roll is reported to purchase the land if the debt isn't paid.
Oh no, what now?
Our story begins in a school in Shropshire, a school which once was one to admire. But Adams was struggling to pay its dues. Then Mr. Hickey got the terrible news.
Is this the letter?
It is.
Oh no. Oh, Ofsted inspection. Immediate demolition? Unless you are immediately able to pay debts to the sum of £1 million, the school will be scheduled for closure. Right, I better make a call on speed dial.
In a final effort to find support, Mr. Hickey called the last resort.
It's got to be this one.
For his last port of call, the headmaster was no fool. He rang the best captain in the history of the school.
Hello?
Chris, thank goodness you picked up.
Carry on, you idiot! No, you were saying?
Chris, the school is in trouble. We need
your
help.
No, that's not right! That's not right! Stop it! Oh, sorry. Carry on.
Ofsted. It's the end of Adams. The sixth form have got so big, on a roll have managed to open up an incredibly successful supermarket chain and have offered Ofsted £1 million to demolish the school so they can build a mega store. Chris, we need £1 million to save Adams.
Say no more. I'll be right on it. Right, it's business. Front team, we have a job to do.
Once more gathered by the famous goatee, the front team gathered but couldn't agree. However would they raise all the dough? With all this arguing, we may never know.
Oh God! Quiet! Please! I can barely ever sound my own voice. Thank you. Now first things first, where's everyone else? Where's the brains, the mastermind?
6,000 miles away in the land of Peru, boarding Captain Peter was on a gap year or two.
Hello?
Hey, Peter, did you get Chris's call? Where are you?
What?
The school's been shut down. We need £1 million.
No,
we need
sorry.
Your help.
I can't. Yeah, I'm actually my gap year right now.
Wait, another one?
Another one. Okay, yeah. Right, now I'm with, yeah. I mean, it does take some time to, you know, discover yourself sometimes, so... But yeah, it's not a problem. I'm actually in Pará right now. You know Pará, Lucy? Yeah, Pará. Yeah, anyway, what was it you wanted?
Okay, whatever.
Jeez. You alright?
Sunny!
I've been really
sad! Yeah, how you doing?
Hey,
how's it going, Mike? How you doing? Mike? How you doing? Mike?
Guys, I think I've got a plan.
Mikey came up with a genius plan just when the team's despairing began. To raise the funds and save the day, they'd win the school's million the sporting way.
Breaking news. The 50th National Pong Championships will be taking place in Newport, Shropshire, later today, with prize winnings of £1 million. Favourites to win are the reigning champions, the one-hit wonders, although a new rookie team have made their unprecedented ascent to the top of the leaderboard. Could the front team knock the wonders off the top spot?
The team soon realised that their pong game wasn't great, so began their training. Keep smiling, mate. And with librarian Caitlin on tactical skills, the team came closer to paying the bills. At last in the final versus one hit wonder. Will the team win the game or will Adams go under?
There's just one game left. Phil, it depends on you.
I just can't do it all on my own.
There'll be no repercussions of you doing everything without the help of your team.
I just can't do it all by myself. I don't want to do it anymore.
You can do it, my boy. You just have to believe in yourself. Find a place inside of you that makes you happy. Find peace, and you can achieve anything. Do not worry about the money or the game. Just let everything go. Do not go through the ball. Let the ball go through you.
Thank you, sir. I can do it now.
It only took a speech for Mr. O to realise Phil had been distracted, took his eyes off the prize. He returned to the game more focused than before, his shot now crucial to the team's winning score.
You can do it, my boy. Let the ball go through you. Go through you.
And with Phil's final shot going into the cup, the whistle was blown and the time was up. One hit wonder reduced to a wreck. Our team could at last cash the £1 million cheque.
Isn't it nice having everyone back together again?
Everyone? Wait, there's only 8 of us. Where's Peter?
I think he's still in Perak.
So we're just 9 of us. Who are we forgetting?
Emily!
Where is she now?
I heard she quit her career in medicine. Some bloke said she had potential in the arts.
Stand up. I repeat, will the real Slim Shady please stand up? We're gonna have a problem here.
Y'all act like you never seen a white person before. Jaws gone on the floor, like having Tommy just bursting the door. It's like whooping her ass worse than before when they first were divorced. Ah! It's the return of the... No way, you're kidding. Did he? Dr. Dre said, nothing, you idiots! Dr. Dre said he's locked in my basement! Eminem, chicka 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 Slim Shady, I'm sick of him, look at him, walking around, grabbing his you know what, flipping the you know who. Yeah, but he's so cute though.
Stop that utter filth in my hall, that's disgusting.
So the money was raised and the team saved the day. Adam's future was secure, as was always the way. Our heroes left Adams in merriment and laughter, and though they'd miss it, they knew they'd live happily ever after.